community and sponsored by Synergetix and Microsoft. Our ATC community is open for all the people who are interested in Microsoft Cloud technologies. You just need to follow up our meetup groups, which is Emerging Technology Community, Azure Tech Community Pune, Azure Tech Community Nagpur, Azure Tech Community Surat, and AI on Microsoft Platform Communities. So these are the communities, our meetup communities. You need to just install Meetup app on your phone and follow our communities. Okay. So you'll be updated with our upcoming event and meetups and webinars. So the next slide, please. A small code of conduct. So this is our small code of conduct. You cannot take the screenshot and you cannot record the screen. Okay. If you want the recording of this webinar, so you just have to follow our YouTube channel and you will get the recordings over there. Okay. So today's session is all about. Hello. Today's session is all about building IoT solution with Microsoft Azure. And this session takeaway is Azure IoT Reference Architecture, IoT Hub, Stream Analytics, Azure Function, Azure Cosmos TV. And today's speaker for the webinar is Mr. Navjyoti. I'll give you a small introduction about him. He has 15 plus years of experience in the field of software development, consulting, and architecting. Currently, he is extensively working on Microsoft Cloud Platform in the field of AI and application modernization. He is a MCT, complete various Microsoft certification in the past. He is currently working with Synergetix as AVP of technology. Now, I would like to hand over the mic to Mr. Navjyoti sir, but before that, here are some cool announcements that we want to make. So before Navjyoti sir starts, so we are running a special campaign, Synergetix and Microsoft running a special campaign in the month of December that is related to your LinkedIn. So if you have completed your certification and if you didn't updated it on your LinkedIn profile, so I'll request you to just go and update the certification. And also add, there's an option called skills and endorsement. Okay, so I'll show you how to do it. We have the slides prepared for you. So under skills and endorsement, you have to add a skill as Microsoft Azure and just update it. So I'll repeat, one, you can add your certification, completed certification. If you don't have certification, you can add your skills as Microsoft Azure. And once it is done, you just have to share this screenshot or screenshot with us, or you can just let us know. So under this campaign, we are giving prizes like Sennheiser headphones and Microsoft Surface laptops for the lucky winners. So the entries will be by 25th of December. Hello. Now can you hear me? Everyone can hear. I'm
Yes.
getting,
Yes.
yeah, I'm getting some messages that my voice is not clear. I hope it is clear now.
Yes.
So I'll give you a quick announcement again that currently we are running one special campaign that is related to your LinkedIn. So all the professionals who are connected with Azure, they just have to update their skills into their profiles by you just have to mention Microsoft Azure, just save it and share the screenshot. We'll be sharing you the number in the chat box. You can share us the screenshot, or you can share us your LinkedIn profile. Once it is verified, we'll fill out your entry form on your behalf and we'll enroll you under this campaign. So what we are doing under this campaign, we are giving huge prizes like Sennheiser headphones and Microsoft Surface Go Pro laptop. Entries are valid till 25th of December, and raffle opening will be in the month of January, probably in the first week. Okay, so I'll request you after you can also update it after the you can update your skills after the session. Okay. So we after this okay. So this is our upcoming this is our course calendar. Currently we are having 50% flat off on our courses. And so which in so here you have to pay 17,500 for all the courses which I mentioned. So this is including MOC, your vouchers, and training. So we'll be sharing the link to you, where we can if you're interested after the webinar, you can avail this discount. You just have to fill out the form. We are sharing in the chat box. Can we see the certification, please, to the attendees? We are going to. So this is the certificate for the attendees for today's webinar. All you have to submit. All you have to submit your feedback forms. Once we'll receive the form, you'll be getting the certificate on your registered mail ID. Okay. So now I'll hand over the further thing to Jyoti sir. So you can continue now.
Yeah, thank you, Rupesh.
Thank you, sir.
Good afternoon to all of you. Hope you can hear me. And I'm going to share my slide deck. Hope you can see that. Give me a minute. All right, so let's get started. So let me set the context for today's webinar on building IoT solution with Microsoft Azure. So the theme that we picked up is all about aligned with Microsoft certification exam, that is AZ-220. That is all about developing IoT solutions with Microsoft Azure services. But before we get into that, we need to know how the entire the IoT ecosystem is being built on top of Microsoft Cloud Platform. So in 2 hours, we are not going to go and talk about the complete set of service which is available on top of Microsoft Cloud Platform to build IoT solutions. But we are going to get into the overview by picking up a reference architecture and referring to a underlying services who can possibly part of the solutions going forward. But at this moment, so we are not going to explore all the services, and we are going to talk about few of them, but we are going to learn the overall, the idea, the overall ecosystem of the IoT solutions using Microsoft Cloud Platform. And at the end, I'll be talking about a bit of the exam that is aligned with this particular webinar, that is AZ220. So what kind of modules, what kind of services from the Microsoft Azure that you are going to learn during the course of AZ220. Rupesh has already introduced me. My name is Navjyoti Barua. I'm working as an AVP technology at Synergetics. I have been working on a Microsoft Cloud Platform for last 7.5 years, and I have been working with 148 customers to assist building their solutions on Microsoft Cloud Platform in different solutions area, right from the IoT to AI, artificial intelligence, including the data science. And I have been working with the application modernization also at the same time. So how you can re-engineer and re-architect your applications while you are going to run them on the cloud. So that's a kind of job that I'm doing right at this moment. So hope I can give you insight in this solution area, what we are going to discuss IoT on Microsoft Azure. So I quickly set up a few points as an agenda that I will take forward during this 2 hour session. So I'll be starting with the introduction to the IoT. That's number one. And it is not very important for all of us. In fact, that everybody knows what IoT is all about, what kind of benefit the IoT implementations can bring into the business. That is not something that need to be explicitly discussed, but still quickly we'll go and introduce IoT first and then jump into the Microsoft Azure Cloud Platform reference architecture. The reference architecture is all about now how you can interconnect the multiple components together to give a solutions for IoT. That is all about reference architecture. So we'll be discussing different component, which is part of the reference architecture and backed by those services as your IoT services, followed by the Azure IoT services. And then quick introduction, one module that I'm going to talk about, that is IoT Edge. So what is IoT Edge? And end with the overview of AZ220, as I said before also, about the examinations, what are the modules this particular course is going to cover. And that is also I'm going to give you or walk you through, in fact. So it is all about knowing the module, nothing more than that. And of course, the prerequisite to get into this certification at the same time. So let's get started. So if you have any questions in between, so you can hold on your question, so you can ask me at the end of this webinar. I'm happy to help you out with your questions. But I will be not keep looking at the chat at this moment. So once I have completed, then I may go to refer to the chat, and or you can speak to me directly by unmuting yourself. So let's get started then, you know, so as I said, to start it with, what is Internet of Things? That is IoT. So technical definition of the IoT is all about a network of internet connected device that communicate embedded or a device, the data to the cloud for centralized processing in context of the cloud platform. So in this sessions, we are not going to talk about what is cloud platforms and what is Microsoft Azure. We are directly going to jump into the Microsoft Azure and pick up the relevant service through which we can build the IoT solution. So that is what the whole concept or core definitions that we are talking about at this moment. So it is all about connecting millions of devices from the remote locations to the cloud for data, that I can make those data more meaningful to the today's modern business. Because how do I go and get insight to the data and make it more meaningful to the business? So from collecting data from the device and sensor to analyzing those data back on the cloud using multiple services is all about Internet of Things at this moment, what we are going to talk about. So essentially what it looks like, it says that a device site made up of individual device, that is what we call as a things that act as a data source, who's supposed to give me the data. But by collecting the data, what I'm going to do after that? So I'll be going and posting those data back to the cloud. So cloud's supposed to collect the data. And once we can successfully collect the data, then we start analyzing those data. And we are going to be very specific about what kind of analyze or what kind of, you know, data validations or data analyze or maybe data filtering or maybe getting into the inside of the data. There are multiple activity that we are going to do on the data back on the Microsoft cloud. But it is not part of the discussion at this moment. So roughly what we need to understand, the IoT is all about device connecting to the backend services. And those backend service is responsible for making data that is being collected by the IoT device more meaningful to the business. A business can be more profitable. That is the ultimate objectives. So there may be multiple verticals of the business today we talked about. It could be manufacturing, it could be retail, or it could be hospitalities, it could be something else. Everywhere the IoT is being used. But the primary objective of the IoT is how you can bring the efficiency of your day-to-day job, how you can maintain the accuracy that is needed, demanded by the today's business, any given point in time. So that is going to be ensured by the IoT solutions that we are going to build around the Microsoft Azure services. So it's a very important for all of us, the stakeholder of the business, how they are going to look at the IoT solutions for tomorrow. So there may be a few, you know, the technical term that we may go and use it, like real-time intelligence pertaining to an item that we are care about. Like, for example, you talk about smart cities, you talk about smart retail system or smart manufacturing unit and so on and so forth. There may be multiple things. We start talking about all of them as a smart building and so on and so forth. So what is the underlying, you know, technology who made a city smart, who made a building smart? For example, I put a sensor in a building or maybe in a lift of that particular building. The sensor can collect the data, and that data is all about the health of the lift. So health of the lift means whether this lift is working perfectly or not, any given point in time. If they can detect any fault, or there may be a fault is going to happen, maybe in 24 hours, that could be detected by the sensor, that could be detected by the devices. And we can go back and collect the data and send it to the cloud and saying that, okay, I have to do some kind of predictive maintenance by collecting those data. Because we got to know what is going to happen in next 24 hours for that particular lift through the device who has collected the data about the health of this particular lift. So we can send the people back to the lift and fix the problem. So that is something what we talk about predictive analytics, predictive maintenance. Or maybe we can connect to a room within a building to monitor the temperature any given point in time. So my sensor is going to give the temperature every 5 minutes or every 5 seconds or every 20 seconds. It's up to you how you want to set it up. Temperature, humidity, pressure, or whatever it may be, because all those data is very, very critical for the business if you have to maintain the temperature for a particular material any given point in time. So collecting the temperature, collecting the humidities through those devices, sending them back to the cloud, and cloud take a decisions what need to be done on those data by getting inside the data is all about the ingredient to make a city smart, to make a building smart, to make a home smart. So there would be a never ending, example that we can talk about one after another, but we need to go back and understand what is the fundamental here. The fundamental piece of information that I'm talking about, it's all about data, and that need to be processed. So what all are the service who can process the data, who can store the data any given point in time? So we need to understand that this is something that we are going to look at by using or by implementing different service from the cloud platform, because we have been talking about sending data to the cloud from the devices. So today, implementing an IoT is not a big deal at all, unlike the 5 years or 10 years back. So IoT is not something new that today that we talk about. So IoT was there for quite some time, but there was a lot of challenges in different areas, like, talking about communications, talking about, the internet availabilities in the remote places, talking about the underlying platforms, talking about the development technologies and tools and so on and so forth. There are a lot of challenges around the IoT solution, but today everything is up and ready. It's become really, really easy to develop or to deploy or to configure an IoT solutions for a particular business domain any given point in time. So with that background, because that was a background that I'm giving, and with that background, let's talk about how we can visualize if I have to think of creating an IoT solutions. So visualizing in back of your mind would be typically done by some kind of reference architecture. We need to understand how the data will flow, in what positions the data would be processed, who will be processed, and why I'm processing the data, where my data is getting stored. All those things to be logically connected by presenting a reference architecture. And that is what we are going to go and discuss at this moment. So introduction to Azure IoT solution architecture on Microsoft Azure. So as I mentioned before also, IoT solution is all about the three things. The things who are supposed to give you a data, that is all about device and sensor that we talked about. And once data arrived on the cloud, then we bring a lot of services to analyze those data, or maybe to store the data before it get analyzed, or real-time analyze that we are going to do on my data. Whenever the data coming in, at the same time, I want to analyze the data. And then finally, we need to take an action. Action is all about, okay, what am I supposed to do? How am I going to react to those data? It's all about respond to the data. Like suppose I am detecting the anomaly on my data, which was not supposed to be any given point in time. So how am I going to react to them. So maybe there would be a subsystem that we have to build. There would be a different service and system that we need to create and deploy to respond to this data that I was waiting to get. So it can be different from scenario to scenario, use case to use cases. This is all about reference architecture that we are talking about with the three main components. These are the three main components who actually built your IoT solution. So along with these three components, so what are the other things that we would be looking at? Maybe we'll talk about storage. That could be one important service from Microsoft Azure where we can store those incoming data. Or before I store this data or after storing the data, I can say, okay, where do we want me to take those data? I can figure out the route for those data to a different services, saying that, okay, this data is going to be processed by this service. After that, it's going to be processed by another service. So we have to create a pipeline, and that is all about the routing of those data. Because in a different point, you have to make a different decision. And it is only about interconnecting multiple services by creating a pipeline, by creating a route for those data. Whether before you store them or maybe after the storing. You can pull the data from the storage, you do the routing, and then you put the data back into the storage. It's up to you how you want to really create the pipeline that you're looking for. And this is core important component I have been talking about, because getting inside the data is all about analysis. So I want to look for a pattern of the data, how the data is coming from the remote devices, remote sensors. So that is really, really important. By looking at the patterns, probably I can predict how the data is going to be received in next 24 hours or next hours or whatever it may be. So analysis is extremely important in the ecosystem of the IoT solutions. It's one of the components that could be delivered by multiple services which is available on Microsoft Cloud Platform. And finally, I need to take those data. I need to take this, inner working of the data to the stakeholder of the business. And that is possibly we can do it by creating a dashboard that is all about display, how we are interpreting those data, how we are telling the story about the data, what is happening. So we need a dashboard, and people can interact with the dashboard to take an action, what they want. If they are looking at the bad data, how they are supposed to get a good data. So why that bad data has come any given point in time? I would like to know. So all those informations can be collected and consolidated and create a kind of dashboard who can really, really help the business to understand what is happening through the entire pipeline that we are discussing at this moment, right from collecting a data to taking an actions, in between analyzing, in between stories, you know, in between working with some kind of filtering or whatever it may be. So you can do based on the requirement. So coming back to the core subsystem that I'm talking about from the reference architecture, this is the reference architecture people can visualize at this moment, what is going to happen. So if I can explain more a detail. So any IoT architecture or any IoT solution will start with the IoT device. That's number one. And there are different type of device. It could be low power device. It could be IP enabled devices. It could be kind of edge devices. There are different type of devices, but collectively we call all of them as a devices who can collect the data and send the data to the cloud. So they may be one device, two device, or millions of device. Where we go and run the code to collect the data through sensor and send those data to the cloud. So while the device is going to send the data to the cloud have to accept, or cloud have to go and receive those data. And this is typically called as a cloud gateway, the second component of this core architecture. To understand, it is pretty simple. It is not a big deal at this moment. So you have a device, it may be one device or it may be 1 million device, but you have a device who can collect data. And after collecting the data, those data would be sent to the cloud. So in the cloud, we have something called cloud gateway who can receive the data. So who all are the cloud gateways? The name of the service we are going to see sometime from now. But yes, the common name that we can say, it's a cloud gateway. The job of the cloud gateway is to receive data that has come from the device. That's it. But what cloud gateway is going to do with that data at real time when the data is flowing, the stream of data is coming into the cloud gateways? So they make it take a call by creating multiple routes. So what could be the routes that I can identify at this moment? I said, okay, let me go and store all the data in a storage service. Storage is a database where we can go and store my data, all the data that is being collected by the device. That could be a one path. That could be a path one or route one. That could be a route one. The another route they say is, okay, data can be picked up by, this is basically a name called stream processing. So maybe it's some kind of code that I want to run on that particular data. I want to process the data. I don't want to store the data. So that is my route number two. I want to process the data. I want to execute some kind of business logic on the incoming data, or I want to filter the data. Then probably I can go and store it, no problem. But I don't want to directly store my data. I want to filter the data. Then I can go and store in the storage. That could be another path. Or maybe after processing the data, I can work with some kind of user interface, a kind of dashboard in a form of report. I can directly go and say, okay, I want to draw a graph on incoming data. I want to highlight the graph based on some conditions. If the data was not expected at any given point in time, it could be anything. So I'm not going by a particular condition at this moment. So we are just understanding the reference architecture at this moment. Or it could be going and talking about an independent services. It's a business integrations. Maybe sometimes it may be on the cloud, a separate system, separate service, separate applications will take care of the data after streaming those data, after processing the data. It could be coming from the on-premise also, not necessarily that we can connect to the on-premise also. There are a lot of integration service. But it is a business integration. I do not know to whom I want to integrate, which system that I'm going to talk to after picking up the data, after processing the data. Because at the end of the day, what I need to do, I need to take an action. So data is always to be processed, and after processing, then we can respond to the data. So by giving this data to the, you know, LOB or maybe any other integrated system that is interconnected to this architecture, what we are talking about at this moment. But the point is that if you go and practically think of implementing this reference architecture, these services that we are talking about would be replaced by set of services, this component, this box, what you are looking at, this, these are the boxes. This boxes could be replaced by a set of services from Microsoft Azure, and that is what we need to understand. So Azure is going to give us some set of service to work as a cloud gateway. Azure is going to give us some set of service who can be treated as a storage. Azure is going to give us some services who can do the stream processing. Azure is going to give us some kind of service who can create a dashboard. Azure is going to give us some independent system service. Or Azure is going to give us some kind of integrations to the on-premise, extending that from the cloud. So let's talk about a bit more on IoT devices or maybe cloud gateways or maybe all those things as I talked about. Right, so when you go with this IoT device, as I said, if you more elaborate, I mean that devices and along with some kind of services, I see it in the Azure cloud. With the IoT solutions, we talk about two type of IoT device. A normal IoT device and the edge IoT device, IoT edge devices. So we'll be talking about what is IoT edge device later on in the module where we are going to discuss the IoT edge. But at this moment, we are saying that two different set of IoT device. And we can talk about collecting the data from either one of the devices into the cloud through a cloud gateway. And one of the service from the cloud gateway will come as an IoT hub. So one of the service from the Azure is called as an IoT hub who can act as a cloud gateway to receive data from the IoT edge device or an IoT normal devices, the sensors that we are talking about. And those, all these devices that I'm talking about can be provisioned through another cloud service called bulk device provisioning. And there is a service that we are going to see, that DPS, device provisioning service from Azure. So what do we mean by provisioning the service? It means the provisioning means those devices need to be connected to the IoT hub. And in order to connect the device to an IoT hub, we need to do a couple of things. Like, any device cannot connect to the IoT hub. Every device will have an identity. Every device will come to the IoT hub with the credentials. So if the credentials is known to the IoT hub, then you can provision the IoT device, and then IoT device can start sending data to the IoT hub. So we do not want to go into the detail of the implementation at this moment, but I just quickly wanted to tell you what is device provisioning is all about. So device provisioning is not just a one task, it's a set of tasks, because we need to connect those devices to the backend solutions through an IoT hub, what we are looking at as a cloud service. So what are the steps that we need to do during that process is all about device provisioning step, device provisioning task. So it could be a one device, it could be a thousands of device, can be provisioned by using service from the Microsoft Cloud platform. And the rest we talked about, the warm data or cold path and all these things. You know, warm means at the same time when I receive the data, I want to do something. Or maybe I can go and store the data. And then after some time, I want to process the data by calling different services like ML, machine learning, or business integrations, or maybe user management. There may be multiple things that you are going to see on the cloud through which you can go and work on those data, which is being stored for some time in the cold storage. But sometimes you say, no, before I go and store them, as I said before, I just wanted to go and store it and pick up by some process. Immediately, the moment the data come in, it stores and getting process. So it's up to you how you want your data to be processed. Once you want the data to be processed then and there, whenever we receive, or maybe you can store the data for some time and then process. It's up to you. And how you are going to process, what service that you are going to call and so on and so forth, that would be an interconnected. What kind of decision that you are going to make, what kind of actions that you are going to take on those data, incoming data, it's up to you. But these are all interconnected. We should be able to practically do that by subscribing the services who's going to give all kind of services that we are looking at. So apart from this reference architecture, what we say, there are cross-cutting architectural need also. It could be a security or logging and monitoring and high availability and disaster recovery, because this, the three core component is available on Microsoft Cloud. And that is being available through a different set of services. So I don't have to build a system on my own because the system is already there. I just need to configure and start using them in my solution. So high availability and disaster recovery is something the cloud is talking about. That could be a core concept of the cloud. And we just need to figure out the service that I have deployed as a part of my IoT solutions, how we are going to make them protected, secure, how we are going to make them highly available, prone to the disaster recovery, and how we are going to go and log the diagnostic informations of those service, and how we are going to monitor by picking up those diagnostic informations any given point in time. All are inbuilt. I don't have to build a system from the scratch. It's already available. I just need to configure it. So the productivity of the IoT developer on the Microsoft Cloud platform would be really, really making your cloud developer, IoT developer, really, really productive by not writing things on their own, because most of the things is available. I just need to configure them in my solutions and make use of them. So it would be too early to get into the detail, but yes, I am just, this slide deck is talking about, there are a whole lot of services, like these are all services under the banner of IoTs, device support, data analytics, visualizations, and integration. So you talk about MS Flow or Logic App, Web App, Notification Hub, Power BI, Azure Monitor, SD Insight, Data Lake, Cosmos DB. So it is not possible to go after all the service, but these are the service that you are going to use every now and then when you give a solutions for IoT from Microsoft Azure, anytime from now. So when you really learn the course that I'll be talking about, the all those components what you are looking at from the Microsoft Azure would be discussed, and it would be bring into the solutions and make use of them end to end. So few minutes back I was talking about, if you remember, that we talk about IoT Hub, which is acting as a gateway to the Microsoft Azure to get the data from the sensor and the device. I talk about the IoT Edge. There's a quick module on the IoT Edge that I'm going to talk about, what is exactly an IoT Edge. But yes, I mean, you can see the few things. And then suppose you want to do a program or you want to write a program and you want to run that program on the IoT device. Suppose you are a Python developer and you know how to write a device programming using Python. Then you are going to get an SDK from the Microsoft Cloud that how that Python code is going to connect Microsoft Cloud to send the data. SDK. Right, so it is easy for the developer, it is easy for an architect, is it easy for a consultant, because you are not going to build those things from the scratch. You need to know and put them together. That is the things that you are going to do. And it's very, very interesting way of designing and architecting and deploying the IoT solutions at the end of the day. So Microsoft Azure is going to give you some kind of services under the PaaS, that is platform as a service. Microsoft Azure is going to give us a set of service, which is under the, it is not about Azure because, but yes, software as a service that we talked about, so we can use as a ready-made software into our solutions any given point in time. So net, one thing has to come out from this PPT saying that whenever we are going to work on Microsoft Azure, we are going to encounter a whole lot of services. But every service is going to do a very unique things in the IoT solutions that we are going to build in the near future. For that, we need to learn them closely, bring them into our solution. There may be similar service that you need to differentiate among them, which one would be appropriate to your solution sometime. Not every time, but sometime. There would be a set of service who deliver the same similar kind of job. But still we can pick up the right one, what exactly you are looking for from your solutions. That is also eventually we need to understand. So this is how all about coming in, what we have discussed in the previous one. So quick talk about for the developer, what the developer is going to do. So if I want to develop a program to run on the IoT device, so my IoT device platform that we need to know, Windows 10 IoT or Ubuntu Core, you know, are IoT or QNX or Android Automatics. So these are different operating system for whom I can write code and run on my IoT devices. Programming like language like C, C++, Java, C Sharp, Python, all are the different programming languages where we are going to run a program and run on those devices where the operating system could be one of them. And software development kit also that we are talking about at this moment, like suppose I need to collect the data by using a data pin from a device. So I have to use something called device SDK. SDK is nothing but a set of APIs, set of object that is defined within that language that I can reuse them in every application. So it could be a device SDK dealing with the hardware, or it could be a service SDK dealing with the software. So in our case, the software would be Microsoft Azure. So how my device is going to send the data to the Microsoft Azure IoT hub, which was act as a gateway, which is typically acting as a gateway for those data. So we get SDK for all. I mean, like, you know, we don't need to build, or we don't need to think again from the scratch. How am I supposed to write a code? It's SDK is available, documentation is available. You just need to follow them. And you should be able to write your code and make them up and running on any device and support it on supported operating system, what we are looking at. So there's a service device provisioning SDK also, what we talked about later in the previous one. So in the context of the cloud gateway that we talked about, say IoT hub, so again, I said I will not go into a detail of the IoT hub, but your IoT hub is going to implement a concept like security or scalability, the routing, service integrations, device management, and monitoring. All of them are available right from the IoT hub. So let me quickly give you a one-liner for all of them. Security means the device can only send data to an IoT hub if this device is registered with IoT hub. And that is all about securities. So anyone cannot come and start sending data to the IoT hub. That is not going to work. Like suppose you have a cloud that talking about, so you have an IoT hub. So when a device is going to send the data to the IoT hub, the IoT hub is going to ask that device who you are. So device has to go and tell their identities. If the identity is being registered on the IoT hub, then only the device can send the data to an IoT hub. It's completely protected. Scalabilities. I can have a multiple unit of my IoT hub. So suppose my millions of devices sending data. So my IoT hub unit need to be replicated because one IoT hub unit won't be able to deal with the millions of devices from where the data is coming at real time. And routing, we talked about how this data would be moving from one point to another point, how the IoT hub is going to talk to the multiple services, service integration, how the device management. So adding a new device, deleting an existing devices, installing the firmware on the devices and so on and so forth, upgrading the OS on these devices, how we are going to do that, how we are going to monitoring the IoT hub by using some kind of monitoring system. Monitoring means getting into a log, getting into the metrics of the IoT hub by picking up the data and create a dashboard saying that, okay, your IoT hub is doing well. IoT hub is not stopped at this moment, or IoT hub is not available state at this moment, or whatever it may be. So we have to keep monitoring once you deploy something on the cloud. So all of them can be put together from the IoT hub. Device provisioning service also, quick introduction. So we don't need to go and talk about more again, I'm saying. So you can provision one device or multiple device. The device provisioning is all about how we can connect those devices to an IoT hub. There would be a certain steps that we need to do, and all these steps can be done programmatically by using device provisioning SDK with the help of device provisioning service. Because until you provision the device, whether you do it manually or whether you do it the device provisioning service, but you have to do. Otherwise, you won't be able to send the data to the IoT hub. So device provisioning is a service who allow us to automate the provisioning of device with IoT hub. Or I can, without device provisioning service also, I can provision, because then we have to do it manually. Registration need to be done manually. So IoT developer tools overview. So at this moment, we are just talking about the around the Microsoft, because that exam that we're referring to AZ220, exam around the IoT solutions on Microsoft Azure is going to use only .NET as a kind of technology platform. So that's why the Visual Studio has come into the picture along with the inbuilt SDK to develop IoT solution. Writing code against IoT hub, writing code against the event hub. There are multiple services who can act as a gateway. IoT hub, event hub is one of them. So there are a few more tools that you can talk about: SDK Studio, code, command line interface. So, but yes, if you are familiar with one of the tools, you should be able to develop IoT based solutions using Microsoft Cloud. I'm not saying that there won't be other tools to develop IoT, yes, the Java developer or Python developer will definitely use a different tools to write code that can connect to the Microsoft Cloud to send a data or receive data. So it is not to be explicitly talking about SDK. So as you can start writing your code, developing your application, you will get to know what is the power of an SDK. So SDK will give you a bunch of API. So without going into the low level, you can just make use of the API, you are done. So it's basically gives you the benefits to take your product as quickly as possible to the market and production environment. So IoT Hub SDK, like how we are going to go and talk about connecting to an IoT Hub and all these things. So similar concept, talking to the IoT Hub also can be done from all this language with the respective SDK. So net, what we can say at this moment, if I'm a .NET developer, if I'm a Java developer, if I'm a Node.js developer, if I'm a Python developer, you are ready to go. You are ready to go and develop IoT solutions using Microsoft Cloud services. The protocol that is being extensively used, that is again a technical thing. So here we are not going to go and again go to the deep detail of the technical, but you know, for your information, these are the different protocol that can be used by communication channel between the device and the IoT Hub in order to send the data. Or working with this HTTPS, which is a common protocol that we have been using for securing the communication channel between the device and underlying cloud service to whom I am sending the data. There are tools like, these are the different type of commands that we may have to go and use it. So I'm just giving quick run through. So these are the command that we can go and write from the command prompts in order to work with the IoT services from Microsoft Cloud. So I can go to the C prompt of my, or maybe Linux terminal, or maybe Mac terminal. I can go and give those commands. Will allow us to install the IoT extension and start talking to the IoT service from Microsoft Azure. So we don't need to again go into the detail of this. These are the typical syntax of writing interactive command through something called CLI, command line interface, like from the DOS prompt of your system or maybe terminal prompt of your Linux or a Mac machines, that you are going to write this kind of code, this kind of line. So AZ stands for Azure. So he said, what you are trying to do by this particular code? Say, I want to create an IoT Hub. So it's an AZ IoT Hub create, or create can be delete, create can be list. But these are the commands. So what would be the name of my IoT Hub? The name of this IoT Hub is this. Under which group of resource that you want to create, something like that. It's very, very easy to understand what is going on in this point. So before I go into an IoT edge, there are quick two module now. So one module that I have completed, this is the reference architecture of IoT services on Microsoft Cloud. And the various services from the reference architecture that we can incorporate while we really go and implement the IoT solutions for any verticals that we talked about, for any type of business that we talked about. So I just wanted to walk you through a few things which is available today on Microsoft Azure. what we are discussing at this moment through reference architecture like IoT hub, like storage we talked about, because where I'm going to store my data, like processing those data at real time when the data will come from the IoT device, so that you will get to see a quick, or you will get to do the quick understanding of how the data is getting processed, who is sending data, who is receiving data, where you are storing those data. So I'm going to give a quick demo that you will understand the complete workflow, what we have learned so far. So I'll take you to my development machine. So in my development machines, I just wanted to talk about what I'm going to do. Suppose you have a set of devices. This is your device. And device is going to collect the data using some sensor. And you are collecting the data. And after collecting the data, device is going to send this data to the cloud. And we know that the cloud has a gateway called IoT Hub. We'll receive the data and give this data to some other subsystem or service for the processing. And after processing, it can be stored or it can be displayed on the dashboard by creating an UI. Or I can store in a database for future use. So there are a few services that we are going to see that how this is going to happen. Now, I cannot get a real device at this moment. I'm going to get some kind of simulated device that you will get to know how the simulated device is going to generate the content, generate the data, and send this data to the IoT hub, and then pick up by the real-time processing and give this data to the storage or maybe UI. So we are going to go and implement this. Not this UI part of it. Just to go and just quickly make you understand how things work. So step number one, I'll go. Currently, I am in the management portal. This is where the Azure service can be accessed. I log in with my credentials because all the service that I'm going to use from this portal is a paid service. I have to pay for everything that I'm going to use because cloud is pay as you go. Today I started creating the service, means from today onwards, I have to pay for those service. So I'm going to create an IoT hub. So from my marketplace, I go and look for an IoT hub. I get this IoT hub. From the list, I create this IoT hub. Okay, I create a logical group for this thing. So I say, IoT resource group. And then I'm trying to deploy this IoT hub somewhere in the East US. And I'm giving the name of this IoT hub. I said my IoT hub 001. And the rest, I just take the default and I just simply go and all those things would be discussed if you align yourself with the AZ-220. But at this moment, we are quickly going and deploying an IoT hub. So this is done in the background. Now we are going to go and do the processing part of it. So I'll go and create the processing is a function app that is what is being extensively used on the cloud to process the data. So I pick up the function app. Here is the function app. Function app, the processing part of it. So let me go and create the function app. Pick up the same resource group. Here also I go and type my function 001, something like this. It is already available. I'm just changing the name because it's associated with the domain, so you have to give a unique name. So I can go and select the runtime. So I select the Node.js code that I'm going to write it, or JavaScript, on the same place where I have deployed my. So I can go and say REST, I can go with the default. This is what I'm creating the processing part of it. And I'm creating this. And this is also done. Then I have the DB, I'm going to create the DB. And I'm going to select the Cosmos DB. The Cosmos DB can store data in a form of JSON. So I pick up the same group where I am placing. So here also I said my Cosmos DB001. It's already available, so I just put my abbreviations there. So I select the location, the same location that I have been selecting. And I will keep REST is default for me. This is the one of the stories. And I can create this Cosmos DB also. So in the notifications, I can see something is being done. So I can go to my dashboard. So I am putting this IoT Hub, the first one in the dashboard, the rest is still progress. So let me work on this IoT Hub. So here is the IoT Hub that I select this. Look at this IoT Hub. I can go to the device. Then I have to register my device. That is what I was talking about, the device provisioning. So I say my simulated device one. I create this device. So I can refresh, I can see this device, my simulated device at this moment. My function also got created, who's supposed to process my data. But before that, I will go to my the same device that I have created. I go and copy the connection string of this device. This is the connection string of the device. Then I can go up to my device and say, okay, this device is going to send the data to the IoT Hub. So device is being registered. So that registered device would be using this connection string. So I say, go to my simulated device. Raspberry Pi web simulator. So this is my web simulator. And in that code, this is the Node.js code. And there is a connection string. You see the device connection string. So what I have copied from my IoT hub, I said, okay, this device is going to talk to the IoT hub in order to send the data. I paste the connection string. Here it is. So I'm ready with this device. They have a sensor LED. So this is the board where we can install our program and all to collect the data. So this device is going to read temperature and humidities in a simulated way and send this data, temperature and humidity, to the cloud. And cloud is going to receive in IoT hub. This is the IoT hub. And after receiving this IoT hub, as your functions, that is the processing unit, here we are talking about, is going to go and receive the data and process something. So here I can go and say, okay, let me go to the function. The function is as of now empty, so I have to write a code to the function. So we can go and add a function. And I will look for a functions template that I don't have to build things from the top. So I'll get a function, something called IoT hub. So there is a function which said a function that will run when the IoT hub received a new event from the IoT hub. So I can say simply go and where is my IoT hub? I can go and connect this IoT hub, which already I have created. This was the name of my IoT hub. So working with the built-in endpoint. And the name of the function is IoT hub, event hub, or whatever it name. So I can say my IoT hub function, something like that. So you can give any name out there. So with that, I can add this. So I'm connecting that piece of code that I'm going to get now. Okay, this is the code of my function. So where I'm going to get this code. So I replace my default code here with some code like this. And I save this code. So what this code is trying to tell me, the code is saying, okay, collect the data. What kind of data? The humidity and temperature data that you are talking about. Collect this data. And do some kind of intermediate operation. So adding those data into it, and then do something on this. Something like taking the average of the temperature, taking the average of the humidities that is received at IoT hub from the device that we are talking about. It doesn't matter what we are doing because it is only to showcase you. But after doing this, after this particular piece of code, who has got an input and an output? So who will be the output? In this scenario, from this processing, the output would be DB. So this already, it is under the process. It's still going on. The deploying the Cosmos DB is still going on because it takes some time, but I have another instance of the Cosmos DB. I can connect that. So I can see this, what is happening out there. This is the input binding that we have it with this particular code that we are looking at. And then I go to integrate that. So for integration, look at this as of now. So the function is taking data from the IoT hub, but after processing the data into the functions, it's going to give it to the output. Who is the output? Cosmos DB. So I go and add that output. Click on the adding output. So I'll select the Cosmos DB, the type of the output. Here is the name of the database in the Cosmos DB's or the output parameters, output document. Sometime back we have seen that this is something what we see, output document, and the name of the collections where the data is going to go, and I want to create this database and collections under which I want to put my data, and I want to select that Cosmos DB. So I go to the Cosmos DB. I have already a Cosmos DB which has got created. This is also got created, but I'm using the previous one. This is perfectly fine. And I said, okay, with this. So I'm connecting. This is the workflow, exactly what I'm talking about. So all are connected. So my Cosmos DB got connected. So with that, I can go back to my functions that I am building. And I can go to the code at this moment. You remember the output, the parameters that we use there in the code. The output parameter is this one. Output documents or whatever that has come in there. So with that, we can see into my. So we have input and output. The output document, what we get it name as what we receive at this moment. And this is exactly what you say, the output document that we have. This is what we are going to go and get it. So binding is an output document. The output will going to give the data. So with that, the things are ready at this moment, so I can go to my device and I can run this device. If everything goes well, so this device will start blinking with an LED and it starts sending the temperature and humidities. And this device is going to connect to the IoT hub. First, this device is going to connect to the IoT hub. In fact, we do have a Cosmos DB also. I pick up the Cosmos DB where I'm connecting to. This is the Cosmos DB where my data is going to store. That is what the connection, the three component with your. So first thing, I will go and check my IoT hub in the displays. So was there any message that is being received by that? So maybe that number will keep changing at this moment, but maximum we can send to the, you know, 400 thousands of messages per day. That is the quota of my IoT hub that we have created. But the message will start popping in. The event is start popping in. Then it will go to the functions. Immediately it will call this processing unit that we talked about. And I select the functions, I can monitor this function. And the function also will 26 times this function is already being called. So this is what I'm talking about. This processing is 26 times is called. So it means the 26 temperature and humidity is already being processed. But after processing, where the data has gone, so I'll go and find that data in the permanent storage like Cosmos DB. I go to the Data Explorer under the Cosmos DB. I see there is a database by the name called Out Database. That is exactly, there's a collection by the name called My Collections. Under the My Collections, you get exactly the same Everest telemetries and Everest humidity. This is what you picked up from this processing unit. You have calculated the average. So entire workflow got working. And now tomorrow, the processing can give the data to some machine learning or maybe UI where you can go and draw this. And you can also respond to the data that is coming in, saying, oh, I want to take an action. I want to make a call to a Logic app or maybe some other service on the cloud. But you get a fair idea of what is happening at this moment, how this data is getting from this simulated device. In the real implementation, it would be real device somewhere in the remote locations, somewhere in the smart building that I started with this today's training. So I can stop this because, you know, since everything is working for us, we can see my data coming in. So ultimate data, all this collected data that we have received at this moment in the back end. So tomorrow my workflow could be a 20 service. They are interconnected by using a reference architecture because I may need to do a lot of things. I may connect to the stream analytics. The stream analytics could be another one. Like, for example, I can go and work with the another this processing part. Instead of functions, I want to do a real-time analytics. Means whenever the data comes in, I want to analyze those data. So there is a service called Stream Analytics. So you can always go and create Stream Analytics. So I'll go and create a Stream Analytics job. So here I say my STA. I put in the same resource group. It's just a quick one unit of stream analytics job. Now, what is that stream analytics can do? So stream analytics can go and I can get my stream analytics also with to my so I can refresh that so it should come under this. I get a stream analytics job so I can pin it to my dashboard for quick access. So here is the stream analytics. I can step into the stream analytics now. And I can go and say, okay, stream analytics is going to take an input from where? The input can be IoT hub. So there is an input, say IoT hub. I select the IoT hub. I said my input. So input automatically pick up this IoT hub. Everything is picked up automatically. You can see that. Similarly, I can go and set the output. So I want to put this output to where I want to put this output. I can put it into the Cosmos DB also. I can pick up the same Cosmos DB that I want, my output. So what is my database name? What is the container names and all these things that I can put it? So I'm not going to go and create another. It will take some time, but I'm just trying to figure out how it can be done by using stream analytics. So I can say the container name. Right, so this is something that we can see this. I can save that. So you have an input and output. So your input from the IoT hub and output, but in between the input and output, the stream analytics is going to run the queries. And that is something all about because I do not have that container. So I get it. So in between the input and output, so the query is, and this query, I can use machine learning algorithms here. So suppose I want to find the anomaly of my data, I can run it here itself. That is called real-time analytics, getting inside the data and understand the data coming in. So this is a simple query, select all from input and giving all to the output without doing anything. But we can do a lot of things by writing a logic here, by incorporating the logic coming from the algorithm like machine learning. So like that, we have multiple service at this moment. I mean, because, you know, you can... This is what we go back and talk about the reference architecture every now and then. So how those component is getting interconnected and to give a final solutions what we are looking at. And quick implementations, probably you can understand how things are going to be. And I'm sure that I'm guaranteed that it is not a big deal for you also tomorrow if you want to create this. Only it's all about going and understanding the detail of the IoT hub, going and understanding the detail of the Cosmos DB, why Cosmos DB, why not something else? Why functions, why not stream analytics? Why stream analytics, why not functions? You know, all those things you would be learning. And then you can go and talk to your customer and say, okay, what is your problems? I'm ready to give you a solutions using the IoT, which is available today on Microsoft Cloud. And in fact, in the Microsoft, if you go to all service under the portal, so you can go and say, okay, I want to see what all are the services available under the Internet of Things. So you can see these are the list of services you can see under the Internet of Things. So it's a huge list. It cannot be done in 2 hours or it cannot be done in 2 days. So it's an incremental learning. You have to learn things like this. You talk about IoT Hub, IoT Central Applications, even grid subscriptions, function app. The few of them probably we are using Cosmos DB. We use IoT Hub, Cosmos DB and function app. In fact, the stream analytics job. But there are many more. But all of them need to be understood and going forward. So it is not a overnight or 2 days you are going to learn things. It's all about building the skill, understanding the customer problem, coming back and subscribe one of the service from the list and going with solution. And at the end of the day, you'll be doing an excellent job if you have a close understanding with all the services what we have at this moment. I don't doubt that. And getting into the all services and nitty gritty, when to use and how to use and all these things, it is all about learning, nothing more than that. And I can guarantee it. And those learning would be really, really good for all of you. So coming back to the last quick two modules. So one was talking about the IoT edge as a concept and going into the overview of this exam. So I'll go back to the PPT. Now, quick concept of an IoT edge today. So we have been talking about cloud, cloud, cloud. I mean, like, so as of now, we talk about all the cloud service right from the IoT hub to the Cosmos DB. Right from the stream analytics to an Azure function. So anything that we want to do inside an IoT solutions today, we need to go to the cloud. This is what the cloud is all about. So what kind of things that we do usually today on the cloud? Gateway, insight, and action. And there are multiple service to perform the insight. There are multiple service to perform the action. There are multiple service to accept the data. The IoT hub, what we have discussed, one of them, one, the 99% used service that IoT hub in the IoT solution, but there are a couple of more. The based on the requirement, we can use them also. But yes, whatever I want to do in context of computing under the umbrella of the IoT solution is typically done on the cloud. People started thinking about it. Why do I have to go all the way to cloud to do the compute that is being done in the inside and action? Or maybe including the storage. Why can't you do it next to the device? The on-premise, essentially I'm talking about the on-premise. Why do I have to go all the way to the cloud and do the computing and come back and implement things in the on-premise from where the device has collected the data? Why can't you put those computing next to the device? And it would be easy. And you are going to deliver an excellent performance on by doing that. If you can bring the, or if you do a reverse engineering, what I am talking about, getting compute back to the on-premise rather than doing on the cloud. So we are not saying that all those cloud computing, what is available around us, is possible to bring them down. This is not possible anyway, but yes. Maybe, which is relevant in context of an IoT, I can bring them down. I can bring it to my my on-premise, bring it to the near to the devices. So if I can put them and run them on-premise next to the device, and the whole concept is basically called as a edge computing today. I'm doing the computing on the edge rather working on the cloud. So you remember that at the time of creating a Stream Analytics job, just few minutes back from my portal, it was asking two questions. Do you want me to deploy this Stream Analytics on the cloud or an edge? I select cloud. I did not select edge. So edge means the device which is sitting next to you. I want to bring it and run that into your devices. The computing module, the module who back that compute on the cloud, can run on your local device. And those devices can be a virtual machines, device can be your physical machines, device can be your mobile phones, device can be your, you know, the IoT, the strong device who support a particular operating system to run the edge module. This is something that I'm talking about. So why can't you get the inside and things back to the on-premise, non-cloud, what we are looking at? So IoT application pattern plus edge. So a lot of things what is happening today on the edge, which is basically enhancing the power of the quick decisions that we have to make, rather we go all the way to the cloud and analyze the data and come back and do the response or apply the response. So decisions making can take some time. Rather going to a cloud, you can make these things next to your device, the decision making process can be faster. And that is all about the IoT is looking at, how fast you can take a decision. We talk about driverless car today. We talk about a lot of things, driverless bicycle and so on and so forth. So they need a quick response. You know, you cannot go all the way and compute on the cloud and come back and take a decision. I don't want to be elaborate on the internal inner working, how the driverless car work, or how the driver, how your, you know, kind of how you can basically use some kind of device in the momentum, you know, and you anticipate a lot of challenges at this point in time, any point in time, and how we can mitigate those challenges. So these are very, very important questions, and those questions is typically answered by edge computing today, because you have to be really fast to react to a particular actions any given point in time. So these are theoretical things, but I don't see a point at this moment to know about more on those. IoT edge modules, it's basically all about containers. There's another technology that containerized Docker, containerized applications that you are going to go and install on the device, IoT edge runtimes. And yes, of course, the cloud-based interface that you can communicate to the cloud. So this is how bringing compute where the data is. That is the theme is all about. So where is your data? Data would be always available next to your device. In fact, in the device itself. So the sensor will collect the data, give it to the edge device. With the help of edge module, what we talked about some time back, I can run different compute which was running till now on the cloud here on the edge device. and all those compute is going to run in a form of container. This is what we are talking about. So there are the few more services that you would be learning, so technology that you would be learning, not just the one. So one of them would be Azure Container Registry. So Container Registry is something where your containerized image would be available, so you can always go and get this container and make them up and running on the edge device. So net again, what is the learning from edge computing or IoT edge? So IoT is being used a lot of compute power on the cloud. Today people are demanded that why can't you get those compute power back to the device who's supposed to collect the data any given point in time. So why we are doing that? Because the decision making would be faster if I can compute those data as soon as possible. So what kind of compute? It could be machine learning, it could be stream analytics, it could be something else. We don't know. It would be defined by the architecture of the solutions that we are going to deploy in some time from now. But overall concept, what I'm talking about, how we understand, how we think about it, how we go about it. So this is an innovations in the field of IoTs. The people never think of that we can run those compute that we have been running after on the cloud. Cloud-based services, why can't you bring them on the on-premise and make them up and running for the better benefits of your business? So you are looking at the holistic development with an entire ecosystem, how it's working towards the only one objective, making your business profitable, making your environments efficient. This is something that very, very important, and it's very interesting in my view. So when you get into this world of IoT and dealing with the services that I'm talking about, and you really, really will be excited in what you're doing. And trust me on that. So getting into the exam, because that is the big questions out here. I mean, like, you know, so what I have been talking about, it's all about the overall ideas or overall kind of understanding how we are going to build the solutions using Microsoft Azure IoT service. And we talked about multiple services, and in fact we have seen a couple of them practically how it's worked. But when you talk about the certifications in that line of services that I'm talking about, the Microsoft has come up with this certifications. The title is Microsoft Azure IoT Developer, AZ220. So what are the modules basically available under this certifications titles? You can see that there are few modules. There's no point going with the module by module, but I just want to walk you through. This is what you are going to learn if you enroll for this course, if you're planning to take an exam, if you want to certify yourself to enhance the credibilities in the field of IoTs, in the field of innovations today, who can really make a difference into a upcoming business. You are really excited, get into the world of IoT. So in order to know things, in order to give a solution, so you need to learn all those things, what we are talking about. So it's a module one, module twos, module threes. As I said, we don't need to go into the detail and nitty gritty of that, but I can just name them. Introduction to the IoT, Azure and the service, device and device communications, device provisioning at scale, message processing and analytics, insight and business integrations, Azure IoT edge development process. The edge also an important component today what I have explained and why it is important today. So talking about a lot of gateway stuff, what is the job of the gateways in the field of IoT is really, really interesting. And how you are going to protect those IoT solutions, talking about all those diagnostic logging and monitoring and testings and so on and so forth, working with containers and device managements along with the securities and all. So as your security centers who talks about, you know, what need to be done, how you're going to protect. So it's a huge, the number of modules that you can see, but it's cover everything that you want to know to give solutions in the field of IoT using Microsoft Azure. Right, so this course provides the students that will skill and knowledge required to successfully create and maintain the cloud edge portions of the Microsoft Azure solution. So it's all about IoT service like IoT Hub, device provisioning, stream analytics, time series, insight, and many more, along with the IoT Edge. So who's supposed to do this? I mean, like, it could be any developer or engineers, or maybe, you know, sometime it could be a consultant or an architect also. They can also need to know the entire ecosystem, entire the technology stacks around giving solutions to the end customers. In my opinions, it is starting with the developer, an engineer, and end with an architect. If you're an architect also, you should be able to, you know, get into this inner working of all those services that we discuss and how they can be interconnected to present a solution in front of your customer. So with that, I have come to a conclusion. So I would like to go and give you a big thank you to all of you for attending this today's sessions. As I said before also, the session cannot give you everything in 2 hours. It is not possible, but you will definitely get a fair idea what is happening for last 2 hours, what I'm trying to communicate you. The three things that I discussed today. The one, to become an IoT developer using Microsoft Azure service, how you go about it. How do you visualize the entire ecosystems in context of a reference architecture? We talk about three things in there. The data, insight, and actions. But all of them would be presented or implemented by different set of services, which is available under the Microsoft subscription banner. You have to buy a subscription and start working from today onwards. And then I talked about a very important modules like the new innovations in the field of IoT, that is IoT Edge. How you are really working in a reverse engineering, like, you know, so you are supposed to run your compute on the cloud, but now the cloud has come to you, that you can run computer next to you, next to your data, next to your device, on the device, who's supposed to collect the data for better decisions, quick decisions, for better accuracies, and so on and so forth. And finally, I talked about how do I certify yourself, you know, how you basically tell the rest of the world is that I do have the credibilities in the field of IoT that I can go and give you the solutions. And that is only possible by certify yourself on this particular track that I'm talking about. So if you are a developer, if you are an architect, if you are an engineer, you should definitely think about to become an IoT developer. With that, again, I would like to thank all of you. And my mail ID is there right itself, and my team working in the back end will definitely help you to understand your query going forwards. So once again, thank you all of you.
Hello everyone. Thank you so much.
Hello.
I hope
everyone can. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Nagyoti sir, for this wonderful session.
Thank you.
Building IoT solution with Microsoft Azure. I also want to thank everyone for joining today's webinar. So before we close, I'll request everyone's 5 minutes. Just a quick overview about few announcements that I want to repeat again. I hope my screen is visible to you all, right?
Not yet.
Is it visible now?
Yes.
Okay. Yes.
Quick announcement again. As we have said in the start, that currently we are running one special campaign that is related to your LinkedIn profile. Okay. So after this session, all of you, as you have got the knowledge about this topic, which is related to Microsoft Azure, so all you can add into your LinkedIn, there's an option called skills and endorsement. You just have to mention Microsoft Azure and just have to save it. We are sharing one form link in the chat box. After updating your profile, just fill out the entry form. Under this campaign, basically Microsoft and Synergetics are giving you prizes like Synergetics headphones and Surface Go Pro laptop. Okay, and entries will be validated till 25th of December, and the fastest entries are going to win. So I'll give an idea how to do it. You'll find an option right in the profile page called skills and endorsement. Here you have to mention Microsoft Azure. As you can see, it is already mentioned. So you just have to add it. Just save it and fill the feedback form. Fill the entry form. You can also, if you have already done the certification, you can add license and certification. This is the calendar, and as we have said, that currently we have 50% off going on our courses. So after training, we are if you are interested in courses, you can fill out the form. We are sharing that form link also in the chat box. And this is the certificate that is going to that we are going to send to the attendees. Before that, you all have to submit feedback form. We'll be sharing you the certificate for today's webinar. Okay, so I'll be sharing you the links for all the things that I've said. Kindly check the chat box, and thank you so much for attending this webinar. Have a great weekend, guys. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Check the links.
Okay, thank you.
Recording will be available on our YouTube channel, so don't forget to subscribe the channel. You can also find the previous webinar recordings over there, so kindly do subscribe. Thank you so much. I've already shared the links. Kindly follow them. Thank you.